Good morning and welcome to worship for this May 31st worship service. It's great that each and every one of you have decided to join us this morning or later in the week for our online worship experience. We are so glad to have you worshiping our living God here with us at this time. Some announcements as we get started with our worship service. If you would, take a moment and let us know that you had joined us here online through a comment down below. Say good morning or hello, or just let us know that you were here and watching, whether it was today, as we first played it on Sunday, or if you're watching it later in the week. We'd love to know when you watched it and where you're watching from. So we hope that you'll take a time during the service to make a comment down below the video. We have a Bible study on Wednesday nights at 6:30. We're doing that through Zoom right now for the next few weeks for sure. If you'd like to join us with that, we'd love to have you. Each week has a different topic and is independent from the previous week, so you can join us at any time. Whether you've already been with us or you want to start new with us right now, we'd love to have you Wednesday nights at 6:30. The login information can be found on our website under our Adult Studies tab, or we also post it weekly on our Facebook page, and it's in our newsletter as well. We'd love for you to take some time also to sign up for our weekly e-newsletter. It's a way to keep up to date with what's going on in the church, to see announcements about activities or other offerings or information that we pass along that we might think is interesting to you. We have a general church newsletter as well as a Kids Zone newsletter for our children's ministry. So you can sign up for either one of those on our website or on our different Facebook pages. We have a church Facebook page and we have one for children and youth as well, where you can find a sign up for those newsletters. We have online giving available for those of you who are watching online. You can continue to mail in checks to the office if that's something you've been doing. But if you are wanting to give weekly and haven't found an opportunity, we do have online giving. You can do that through Facebook, the donate button, or in the comment section will also be a link to an online giving page that we have set up. That page is also available on our website. A few announcements about upcoming changes to our schedule. The office will be back open starting Monday, June 1st. We have regular office hours starting on Monday. We do ask that you set up an appointment to visit with us or to call ahead as you're coming, just so we know you're there. We can keep too big of a crowd from being in the office at one time. So if you could just give us a call and let us know you're on the way, and we'll be there to assist you whenever you need in the office starting on Monday. We'll begin in-person worship on June 21st. So in a few weeks, we'll be back together in worship. There are some changes to our procedures and practices and how we'll go about doing worship for a while here. That document is available on our website. It's also been sent out through our newsletter. So if you'd like to check that out, you can go to our Facebook page to find a link to our newsletter. Our website has an update on our banner about all the COVID-19 updates, and you can find that document there and you can take a look at it. Now let us turn our hearts and our minds to God with this special call to worship for this Pentecost Sunday.
Holy Spirit, come and fill this place with your presence. Embolden us to spread the fire of your Spirit. This day, may we devote ourselves to teaching and fellowship. May we break bread together. And let us pray as Augustine. Breathe in me, O Holy Spirit, that my thoughts may all be holy. Act in me, O Holy Spirit, that my work too may be holy. Draw my heart, O Holy Spirit, that I love but what is holy. Strengthen me, O Holy Spirit, to defend all that is holy. Guard me then, O Holy Spirit, that I always may be holy. May we never cease to be amazed at your works, and may we always remember that you are with us. Amen.
Thank you. To be over. eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. High lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. I want to see you. We see. To see you. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. I want to see you.
Now is our time for young disciples. We invite the children to gather around close to the screen so they can hear this message and be a part of our worship service in that way. Hi kids, how are you today? You know, today is a special day in the life of the church. It's a Sunday that we call Pentecost Sunday. Now the most exciting thing about this is we usually have everything decorated in red. It's not often the church is completely decorated with our red cloths on all the things in the sanctuary, or we might be wearing red clothes on this day, but it's a special day in the life of the church. In a lot of ways, you could call it the church's birthday. That way back when, right after Jesus had gone back to heaven, the Holy Spirit came into a place and connected the people together and made them the church that we know today. The people gathered and knew who God was and knew that they were connected through God. And they came from all sorts of different places, and they spoke all sorts of different languages. But the Holy Spirit connected them so they knew what each other was saying. They knew that each one of them was part of God's kingdom and part of what God was doing in the world. And so today is a special day. It's a birthday of the church. So we can celebrate all day and into the coming weeks and celebrate that the church is here for us and that we can be a part of it. So I hope you take some time to celebrate that with your families and just be excited the church is here and that we will be together in person again real soon to have a great celebration each Sunday. But today, on Pentecost Sunday, let us celebrate together that we have a church that brings us together no matter where we are, no matter who we are, that we are God's people together as a church. So happy birthday, church. Will you all pray with me? Dear God, thank you for your church. Thank you for opening it to us. Help us invite others to be a part of your church. In Jesus' name, amen. Thanks for joining me this morning, kids. Now's our time for offering. And during this season of online worship, we offer up a special song for us to just sit back and listen to the words and offer our praise and thanksgiving to our living God. So let us do that at this time.
Holy, holy, holy.
Our first gospel lesson comes from the Gospel of John in the 7th chapter, verses 37 and 39 through 39. On the last day of the festival, the great day, while Jesus was standing there, he cried out, "Let anyone who is thirsty come to me, and let the one who believes in me drink. As the scripture has said, out of the believer's heart will flow rivers of living water." Now he said this about the Spirit, which believers in him were to receive. For as yet there was no Spirit, because Jesus was not yet glorified. And our second reading today comes from the book of Acts in the 2nd chapter. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like a rush of violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at the sound of the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one heard them speaking a native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in our own native languages?" All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with a new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my Spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portions in the heaven above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." Today's message is entitled, Water and Flames. Ties together our two messages for today, the living water that we hear about in John, the Spirit being sent out to believers, and this traditional Pentecost Sunday reading from the 2nd chapter of Acts. As I thought about a title for this sermon and thought about the two readings and how one's an image of water and one's an image of flames, I thought about how appropriate that is, because it seems so often in our lives, in our church, in our world, that we see things in an either-or split. It's either this or that. And in these two stories, both talking about the Spirit coming to us, it's both water and flames, two things that usually are opposed to one another. One will douse the other out and put it out. But as we think about what God is saying to us as individuals and as a body, as a church, we're to recognize that God is in and of everything, both and, not either or. And so we hear about this promise in John that the living water will come out and be poured over everyone. The Spirit will be sent to the believers to sustain them and to guide them. And finally, in this second chapter of Acts, we hear the birth story. The birth story of the church. It's amazing to me to think about the church in Acts and to really spend time going through it. If you've never done that and really looked at it as an eye to what the church should be and can be, I encourage you to do so. Because it's a challenging reality to live in. They were living in a time where Jesus had just been among them, had been teaching them, had been guiding them, that gave them great energy and great excitement. And then all of a sudden, the disciples were left to lead the believers that were there. They were commissioned with the job to go out and make disciples of all nations, to baptizing each and every person, to bringing them to God through the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. And so we see this group gathered together here in Jerusalem. People from all different walks of life and different places, speaking different languages, and there's this rush of wind. There's this feeling that comes over them, and all of a sudden they can understand each other. They know what's being said. They know the connection. And people from the outside are wondering what's going on, wondering if these are a bunch of drunk people who've gathered together for some kind of party and are causing great shame to the gathering. But Peter stands up and tells them that this is from the prophet. The prophet Joel had told us this. This would happen in the time when God would make himself known through Christ. He says, God declares that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. There was a promise from the prophet Joel that God had said, the day will come when my spirit will fall upon you, and things will be new and changed. Things will open up, and you'll see and hear things you never knew before. You'll be part of something much greater than you ever imagined, something you couldn't even think about. As I got to reading those words in the prophet Joel in the second book of Acts, I began to think about where we are right now in our world and our lives, where we're heading as a church, and where God may be calling us. And I think about how this opportunity in Acts came upon them to create something new, to do something different, to do something unique, to go out of their comfort zone and reach people in a new and a different way. So as I ponder that, I think about how we talk about how we're resurrection people, that Easter Sunday comes about every week, that every Sunday is a little bit of Easter and we live as resurrection people, and that's very true. But I wonder what it would be for us to be Pentecost people, to live in such a way, to get excited in such a way for ministry that we experience the Holy Spirit each and every moment, that Spirit is pushing us and drawing us into relationship with people in different ways, people that come from different walks of life, that speak different languages, that know God in different ways. How we can connect with one another to bring about a revival, to bring about a new fiery spirit within us, to reach new people in Christ's name. Imagine what it would be like that if our young people would see visions and our older people would dream dreams. That no matter where we are in our lives, there's new opportunity and new exciting things happening. That we all get a glimpse of heaven and something new comes about. That we have the opportunity through the risen Christ to live life anew, to do ministry anew, to rethink the ways we've done it, to maybe improve on them or maybe completely do a 180 on them. That we are to call to be disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world. It's one thing for us to be disciples in the sense where we just follow Jesus, that we pray each day, that we reach out to God and know that we need God in our lives. But to fully live out the gospel of Jesus Christ, we have to be disciples for the transformation of the world. We're called to do that to the ends of the earth. It'll be challenging. It'll be hard. It may take us to places and do things we never could imagine. But if we were to live as Pentecost people, we would have the Spirit fill us with living water and flames of passion so that we can transform the world in the name of Christ, that we can build relationships we never thought possible, that we can do things we never thought possible. We may find ourselves coming up with ideas that we think are crazy, but good, crazy is good in this instance. To have the passion to throw out ideas that seem completely out there. Because we throw them all out there, and at some point God points us to one and takes us down that path. And that's the story of being Pentecost people. Being open to the Spirit to say, go do a new thing. Create something new and be something new. That's our opportunity right now. That's our opportunity whether we like to have it or not. We liked the way things were. It was comfortable, and we had control. But God doesn't create these chaotic situations in life, but God will certainly use them. And for this to happen during this time of Pentecost, for us to be worshiping this way and in the world being this way, why not take the opportunity of a reset button in our faith life, in our worship life, in our life as committed disciples of Jesus Christ, to be in ministry with and for all people, to come up with crazy ideas and see a few of them through, so that we can be true disciples who lead others to know Christ, to transform the world, and to experience the Holy Spirit in such a passionate way that we can't sit still. Let us be resurrection people and Pentecost people. Let us feel the living water pour upon us and the flames of the Holy Spirit lift us up. Let us realize that God is in and through all things. That things are possible we never could imagine if we trust and listen for the Spirit and let that fire burn within us, that it drives us to a new frontier of ministry. May it be so in each of our lives, and may it be so in our life as the Church of Jesus Christ. Amen.
This is Pentecost. Everything is different. Everything is new. Everything. This is the birth of the church. The wind swirls, a hurricane blows, the stale air is forced out, the dust disappears in an instant. The air is fresh, the light is all around, the Holy Spirit enters our lives and we become a new creation. It turns us around, turns our lives upside down, blows away the stale and the old. Christ enters our lives and we are made new. We are made whole. This is the birth of the church. We are gathered here in this place, in this time, to be something new, to refresh the old, to reboot the past, to be the church God created us to be the new creation. This is the Pentecost. God is here, Christ is here, the Spirit is here, and we are part of it. We are the new creation.
Now is our time to be in prayer with and for one another as God's people. Our prayer requests are up on the screen. I invite you to lift up those prayers today and each day during the week. Pray for these people and situations that they may feel the presence of the body of Christ, lifting them up in prayer even when they don't know that you're praying for them. May they feel God's Spirit with them as we worship in different places at different times, but worship together as one church, as God's people who care for one another. Let us now turn to God in prayer. Knock us off our seats, O Lord, with the wind of your Holy Spirit. Don't let us just sit back and rest as though nothing important was happening. Remind us that you have come to bless and prepare us for your service. Now is a time of proclamation and celebration. Now is the birth of your church, not as an exercise in futility, but as a dynamic group of people who know you and love you as you know and love each of us. Flame up our hearts. Make us joyful that we find it difficult to sit back and watch. We want to be part of your healing love and mercy. We want to be people who bear the word that your love for us is eternal, that Jesus Christ, our Savior, proclaimed and taught that love in all that he said and did, modeling for us a new way to live. Pick us up and propel us forward into your world. Help us remember that you have given to us what we need to be your disciples. We just need to say a resounding yes to you. Thank you for all your wondrous patience and blessings you pour into our lives each and every day, as we offer our lives back to you in joy and hope, in the name of Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now
from our worship spaces this day, let us hear these words of blessing. Always remember who and whose you are, that you are God's people, that you were created in God's image, that you were fashioned in God's love, to be co-creators of a new world, transformed through the risen Christ, let us go live into the Holy Spirit. Amen.